Well, cheers.
Cheers.
To our first episode.
First one.
Oh my God, you guys.
Woo. So welcome to Two Buzzed Girls.
This is a channel about happy hour. Being a broke millennial, we live off happy hour. LA has so many happy hours. It's like, which one do I choose?
There are so many of them.
I'm in the West Side, but I like going downtown.
And I'm in the Valley because it's a lot cheaper there. So sometimes I drag her to my area.
Yeah.
What we like to do is share our happy hour experiences with everyone else. And sometimes maybe even adding stories and conversation into that too, because it would be entertaining if it was just food.
Hopefully you find this entertaining. You come back and you watch it. If anything, we're just hoping that what you get out of this is the happy hours around Los Angeles and cheap places to go after work. And the great thing about happy hours in Los Angeles is that some of them are daily.
What we're gonna do is when we go to these places, we wanna share with you the best items at those places. We order the things that we think we'll like or things that are different that we've maybe never seen anywhere. And we just wanna give you a review on which ones were our favorites.
And sometimes happy hours just have wine or beer, which is totally fine because those places have been an extensive wine list, which I love, but also an extensive beer list. And if you're looking for a particular type of beer and it happens to happen on happy hour, we will let you know.
By the way, I have never drank wine out of a straw, but apparently that is her thing, so now I'm drinking wine out of a straw.
Ladies, you know the lipstick is very important. That sucks when it gets messed up. I actually want to buy like a metal straw so I can carry it around to our happy hours. You may see me with a metal straw at some of our happy hours, eventually. Not in this episode. Should we?
Hopefully not for a long time.
Should we talk about the black hat?
Let's do it. This is our first happy hour together.
Just want to give you a heads up that the quality of the filming is subpar.
But keep in mind, we are also Two Buzzed Girls, so even if we have the best camera, sometimes the quality of the photos and videos may still be subpar. One of the first places to go was the Black Cat, which is very appropriate because between the two of us, we have four cats.
Yeah.
So anything cat related, we're good. Black Cat, which is in Silver Lake.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely the hipster capital of LA.
It's like Brooklyn, but in LA.
I have nothing else to compare it to because I'm from Indiana and there's no hipster areas really. Parking wasn't too bad. We actually both found spots within like a block. It was pretty good. We went on a Saturday. This is one of those that we were able to do on a Saturday.
Yeah. Just a block away, I parked and had no, I wasn't circling a lot, so.
It wasn't too bad.
Yeah, you found parking pretty quickly.
Pretty quickly. So when you get there is an outdoor seating area that was packed. So it was one of those things that we definitely didn't sit there. We wanted to sit inside hoping that would help with our quality of photos. I don't know. Whatever. It was not insanely busy, which was good. And then it did start to pick up the longer we were there.
It is really nice inside there though, I have to say. Like I really like the booth that we sat at. The bar was really packed, so there was no choice in sitting at a bar, unfortunately. So now here's our menu.
Here's the menu.
Here's the menu. Black Cat has it on their website, which is really nice. So if you want to take a look at it beforehand, you can do that. Or you can just screenshot this right here.
Or right here. We're not really sure where it is yet. So if you take a look at the menu, you can see the different options that we had, but we definitely only wanted to order something that was on the happy hour menu. And I think we had a pretty good variety of things.
Yeah. And for people that are pescatarian and vegetarian, they definitely had those options. All right, drinks.
Our favorite part.
Yeah.
I actually ordered the Dark and Stormy. Funny thing, I was actually gonna order the Salty Dog because I'm more of a vodka drinker. But when she came over to take the order, I was looking at the Dark and Stormy, so that's what came out of my mouth, so that's what I ended up with. I'm not a huge rum fan, so I wasn't as excited, but I was like, you know, I'll try it. Sure, let's do this. It was actually really good. It wasn't as heavy as a lot of rum drinks I've had. It didn't taste like alcohol, which is very dangerous, but also very good. Overall, it was pretty good. I would probably order it again if I was feeling something different, you know, trying to adventure out of my normal vodka slash wine bubble. But yeah, I would consider it a really good rum drink. It's a really good option on that happy hour menu.
I tried it as well, and I do like rum, and you're right, it's dangerous.
And it was pretty strong too.
Yeah, you could have three of those easy, just like,
three of those, I would need to take the weekend off.
what you were doing and leave and not realize that you were at the Black Cat.
I think it was a good accidental word.
Yeah.
I was happy with that.
Yeah, it was really, really good. I don't drink rum a lot, but I do like it. So I'm not opposed to drinking it. And I was gonna order it, but I saw that Aperol Spritz. Aperol Spritzes are really hit or miss, but I was totally in the mood for Aperol Spritz.
She kept talking about it, yeah. So it was pretty good.
I love Aperol Spritz. The thing with Aperol Spritz is that it can either be really, really good or really, really bad. Like, I had one in Texas a few years ago that tasted like chemicals. It was not good. This Aperol Spritz was absolutely perfect. It was the perfect amount of orange. It was bubbly. It was light. It was refreshing. I was so excited. I wanted to order like three more and then...
She tried to.
Yeah.
And if you had three of those, you'd be carried out, not walking out.
Yeah, that's true. I don't feel like having those nights again.
I'm 50-50. Happy hours are 50% about the drinks, 50% about the foods. I love food. So we did decide on a couple different items. If you look at the menu, we tried to make a variety.
We ordered chips and a ranch dip with caviar.
If you don't eat chips that have caviar on it, are you even eating chips?
I am a big like chips and dip person. So when I see that on the menu, I'm like, that's my go-to.
Oh, that's so good.
Along with the chips, we did order the peppers, which were peppers stuffed with goat cheese and wrapped in bacon. Neither of us really care for peppers. I'm not supposed to eat cheese, but I do anyways because I do what I want.
I don't discriminate against any cheeses.
And then we saw bacon. So add that in there, and that was a sold for us. We sacrificed in order to supply you with the information that you need to make a wise decision next time you're at Black Cat.
There was a lot of bacon.
It was really good.
And that's wonderful. Really, really never a bad thing.
The third item that we got was the slow roasted pork ribs, which we knew were gonna be messy.
Not be a first date meal, but be so crazy. So that's like fall off the bone. Amazing.
My mouth's watering.
I want them like right now.
Overall, we decided we wanted to let you know out of the items that we chose, which ones we liked the best.
So here's my ranking.
And here's mine.
Number one is the slow roasted pork ribs. Those were the favorite of the day.
They were definitely the favorite.
So good.
And they were different. You don't see them in all the happy hours. Pork's not as common as some things. So overall, yeah, definitely those were the best.
Number two, the chips and dip.
No.
Yes.
Number two is the peppers.
No.
She doesn't even get a say. She didn't even eat the peppers. She literally spooned out the cheese with the bacon and left the peppers on the plate. You can't even give a valid opinion of where it ranks because you didn't eat it.
I did try it. I really did put it in my mouth and I was like,
you could have tried harder. Okay, we'll agree to disagree. I think the peppers were second, she thinks the chips are second. And which one do you agree with the most?
Yeah, let us know. We need to settle this debate once and for all.
I mean, I know I'm already right, but you know, it'd be nice to have some backup.
Unfortunately, we didn't order the other drinks, but that's for you guys to go and try.
You can, and let us know if they're worth going back for, because at this point, I'd like to go back and try them.
But if we
missed something, you know, I'd like to know. But overall, I think we should probably go back and try them, but let us know what you think.
Yeah, let us know like what we missed and what we really need to try, and maybe we'll go back. But there's so many happy hours in LA that
that's true.
We've got to hit them all, you guys.
It's our job. Somebody's got to do it.
Yeah.
Continue following Two Buzz Girls. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And to see more, follow us on Instagram and Twitter.